As of December 1st of 2024, there are currently 48 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, the same number as were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Iceland's Reykjanes volcano, situated 36 kilometers southwest of the nation's capital city, Reykjavik. This fissure system is currently on day 12 of its 7th eruption during the last year, but at the present, weak activity is thankfully only sending lava effusively away from nearby structures and points of infrastructure. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In California, an unusual earthquake swarm struck the Mammoth Mountain volcano, resulting in more than 24 earthquakes striking within 4 hours of each other, some of which were large enough to be felt by nearby residents. Heading over to the island of Sumatra in Indonesia, the Dempo volcano seemingly had its first shallow magmatic intrusion in recorded history, causing large sections of its deep crater lake to evaporate away in a matter of hours. And on Indonesia's island of Halmahera, the erupting Dukono volcano produced its tallest eruption column in recorded history. As one of the world's most active volcanoes, the Dukono volcanic complex provides a fascinating display of the Earth's power, frequently ejecting ash and bombs of lava beyond its central crater rim. Yet, the eruption, as shown in this footage, only represents moderate activity. The intensity of its eruption, which has been ongoing without any pauses since 1933, seemingly increased on November 26th. Normally, Dukono produces fairly frequent Volcanian eruptions that eject ash to heights of 100 to 2,000 meters above its summit at a rate of a few times a day, and when this is not occurring, it instead releases continuous emissions of gas. Yet, all of a sudden, just before midnight struck on November 25th, the emission of gas at its summit completely ceased. Volcanic tremor then began as pressure built up at depth, as clearly a plug had formed in the volcano's magma conduit. This volcanic tremor continued to get more and more intense, remaining for nearly 10 hours straight. Then, at 9:43 a.m. local time on November 26, the plug finally broke, resulting in a 5,687-meter or 18,658-foot-high eruption column and moderate ash emissions. Despite this representing the tallest eruption plume and possibly single largest explosion Dukono has produced since at least the beginning of the 20th century, a low regional wind speed at the time meant that what ash was generated did not fall on any regional settlements. In other words, no one was harmed by this andesitic eruption. Heading over to California, a suspicious earthquake swarm occurred this week at the rhyolitic Mammoth Mountain volcano, a volcano which I want to remind everyone has not erupted since 1252 CE. Normally, this lava dome complex, which is popular with winter sports enthusiasts, especially during the current month, only averages 0.9 positive magnitude earthquakes, or events above a magnitude 0 per day. Yet, when a 1.6 magnitude earthquake struck at 10:53 p.m. on November 26, it was followed 14 and 30 minutes later by two additional micro-earthquakes. Then, between 12:43 and 1:11 a.m. on November 27, 16 earthquakes struck one after the other, all at shallow depths on the same section of the volcano, that being its northwest. Two of these quakes were large enough to be felt by sleeping residents of the nearby town of Mammoth Lakes, one of which registered in as a magnitude 3.8. While the number of earthquakes would soon after return to normal levels, something unusual had clearly occurred. These quakes represent an actual earthquake swarm and did not follow the 1 over X rate that is expected in aftershock sequences. Also, they all occurred at incredibly shallow depths between 200 meters below sea level and 250 meters below the surface at the top of the mountain. I have a suspicion that these quakes were hydrothermal in origin, perhaps being induced by melting snow seeping into the underlying water table. This may have triggered a series of quakes to occur at what may be an unmapped fault which runs perpendicular in between two known faults. In other words, what had just occurred was almost certainly not volcanic in origin. Meanwhile, on the island of Sumatra, the Dempo volcano erupted for its second time in a week on November 26, ejecting ash and acidic water to a height of 100 meters above its crater lake. However, the following day, it appears that a batch of magma for the first time started ascending up to shallow depths underneath its summit instead of remaining at several kilometers depth. This caused a section of its crater lake to heat up and rapidly evaporate, quickly decreasing its depth by 6 meters or 19.7 feet in only an hour and a half. And then, nothing. No further evaporation occurred, suggesting that the magma intrusion likely stalled at depth. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 30th of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member Darla Suit for supporting my work.